Praise the living God. We thank God for this wonderful time and a great time giving to us to be into His presence. You know, I am so always grateful the moment I am in the presence of God, because I know His holy God is always protecting us, protecting me, protecting my family members, and protecting all the brothers and sisters. I thank God for that. I thank God for His goodness. He's always showing His goodness upon my life, into my life, spiritually, physical, anytime I see the goodness of God. Praise God. Today I would like to share the word of the Lord with you. The topic is, don't lose your conscience. Conscience. Don't lose your conscience. The conscience is very important. I'll say this by the grace of God. There is the first grace of God is if you have born in a royal family, is also is the grace of God. If you have born, your father, your uncle, your grandfather, he can be a president of a country, is also a grace of God. If you have born in the family, your auntie, your father, your uncle, he can be a mayor, it is also a grace of God. Or if you have born, your father or your relative is a general of army, is also a grace of God. Or a commander chief, or a chief of justice, it is also a grace of God. Now, it is also the grace of God we are always asking to appointing our life. Now, don't lose your conscience. You know, in the situation and the problem sometimes we are going through and we are seeing around us, sometimes we lost our conscience. Sometimes you are married because of the situation, or somebody tells you a lot of things, lies about your husband or your wife. You can end up lose your conscience. You can end up lose your conscience and you do bad things. Don't lose your conscience in any situation or problem. Don't lose your conscience. We are going to read in the Bible all the word of God speak to us about the conscience. Let's read in the book of First Timothy chapter 1 verse 18. The Bible says, Timothy my son, I give you this instruction in keeping with the prophecy once made about you, so that by following them you may fight the good fight. You may fight the good fight. It was a recommendation. Recommendation, or like Timothy was a disciple to Paul. He was following the instruction of Paul. So the moment the spirit of from above, from God, appointing the man of God, he released the prophecy among the life of Timothy to say, you are a man of God. Now, he said, keeping with the prophecy, who they have prophesied on you, once made about you, they prophesied to say, this young man, he will be a greater man of God. This young man, he will be a prophet. This young man, he will be a pastor. He will be apostle. It's through revelation from God, through the word of prophecy, they did release among Timothy his life. He received the word of prophecy. He keep it on him. Sometimes we are people, we can receive the word of prophecy, we are not taking of it. Sometimes we reject it. Sometimes we said, usually we always said, they are always prophesying on us, but nothing has never happened. They are always prophesying on us. Let me tell you something. Remember also the moment Sarah, after cooking for the three angels, the Bible says the one was in the middle. He released the words among Sarah to say, next year, in the same time, you are going to have a baby boy. Sarah take time for laughing, started laughing. You know that the way she was laugh, it is a way to say it. They are always prophesying on us. They are always say those words, but nothing, this word are already coming true. That the reason make Sarah to laugh, to say, you are not the first prophet. You can be sometimes the 31, but nothing already happened. So that it just makes that laughing. I'm old like this in my oldness to give a baby boy, to give birth. It's not easy. He just say something. He just say it. Just like that. Just J. But okay, we don't know. So the Bible revealing to us, Timothy also was a man of God according to the word of prophecy. They prophesied on him to say, you'll be a greater man of God. Now, Paul started giving the instruction and they said, so that by following them, you may fight a good fight with faith. You may fight the good fight with faith. So we may fight the good fight with this. He said, holding on the faith and a good conscience and a good conscience. So a good conscience. So some have rejected. Some have rejected this and the soul. So which means some of us they already reject. Fight the good fight holding the faith. Fight the good fight with faith. And keeping the good conscience. Some they already reject. They reject the conscience because they think everything as good. Like in this situation we are going through. Because up to now, we still speak one word to say COVID-19. Now they tell us to say, no, there's a COVID-20. Wow, okay. No more 19. Because like 19 already passed, it become now COVID-20. So we don't know sometimes the end of this year, they will tell us again, COVID-21. So, okay. But I'm not there because it's not my problem. Now my problem is to preach the gospel, the goodness of God. There is some people, in this situation, they did have a lot of money. They did have a lot of money. There is a some, it is a business for them. Some, they just make it like a greater business just to protect themselves. Some, they are crying. They already lose their job. They already lose their business. Nothing is good. Their business is down. Their job is down. Now they are jobless because of this situation. Now, because of this situation, some they recover their life. They receive something. Some they build their bigger house. Some they bought the nice cars. Some they lost their job. Some they lost their position. Some there is nothing to do. Some they are now in question mark. To say sometimes we don't know what are we going to do. We don't know what are we going to do tomorrow. Because we already under this situation. Brothers and sisters, wherever you are, you are watching this message. Just believe and hold your faith. Don't lose your faith and hope and the love. Stand up and don't lose your conscience, because it is this moment who God will change your life. Praise the living God. Because the Bible says, fight a good fighting by faith. Fight a good fighting. So it is not the time to say, I must sit down, I must hand up, I must go back to my life. No, it is not the time to sit down. It is not the time to keep quiet. But it is time we must stand again in the presence of God and to pray to against the spirit of poverty, to against the spirit of sickness, to against the spirit of jobless in Jesus' mighty name. And you will see successful it upon you. You know, if Paul spoke to Timothy to say, fight the good fight with faith, which means Timothy also, he was going through a lot of problem. He was going through a lot of problem. He facing a lot of challenge, but he couldn't keep quiet. The Bible tells us, number one, he was still a young. He was young in the ministry. So imagine, you are young in the ministry. Some they can say that you are crook. Some they can say he just in the ministry to do bad things. Sometimes to say no, he just in the ministry to do fornication. Because you are young. Timothy also, he was young. He was stamped up. He was stamped up in the presence of God. And to preach the gospel, to preach again, to against the doors that were against the word of God. In this moment, brothers and sisters, it is not our time to keep quiet. It is a time to stand as one person, to against the spirit of devil, the spirit of poverty, the spirit of sickness, all those spirits, sickness, troubleness, destroy that in Jesus' mighty name. And you will see the greatness, the glory of the Lord. It will upon you. Sometimes you were a Christian. Now you don't have anything to do. Sometimes you don't have money for paying rent. Sometimes you don't have food. Sometimes you don't have a job. You lost your job. Because of this situation, it is not a time who you are stand to blame somebody, or to insult someone, to accuse another person, or to accuse your mind. No, or to accuse your conscience. It is a time to stand up with your conscience. You say, no matter what, God will make a way. No matter what, there is a problem. No matter what, there is a challenge. God will make a way. Something good to be happened. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Brothers and living God. Remember, In the book of John, book of Luke, chapter 19, verse 10, the Bible says, I give you the power to stand upon the snake and the scorpions. Nothing shall harm you. In my understanding for this scripture, I'm always understand to say it. It's supposed Jesus Christ to say it, I'm here to deliver you. I'm here to protect you. I'm here to do great things to you. But he said, I give you the power. I make you to be responsible for your life, spiritually or physically. I give you the power to step on the snake and the scorpions. Nothing shall harm you. Nothing shall stop you. So now we've got the power from God. Because God already gives us the power to step on the snake and the scorpions. Nothing shall harm us. Things can be complicated. Things can be complicated. Sometimes we're asking ourselves, there is nothing we can do. There is nothing we can do because of this situation. Just stand up. Don't lose your conscience. Don't lose your conscience. Don't lose the power of God has given to you. Stand up and speak to God against this spirit of trouble, of poverty, of sickness. In Jesus' mighty name, you will see the deliverance from God. It will be upon you. Because the Bible says, I will deliver my people from the rising sun. And the moment the sun goes down, I will deliver them. They will be my people. And I will be their God. So in this moment as a Christian, it is a time we must stand in the presence of God, and to against the spirit of devil, to against them, and to destroy them, in Jesus, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Because, let's read again some scripture. Still in the Timothy, chapter 6, verse 12. It said the same words, and they say, fight the good fight of faith. Take hold of all of the eternal life which you were called when you made your good confessions in the presence of many. Fight the good fight with faith. So it is not the time to sit down, because we have already confessed the word of Jesus Christ as a Lord and a Savior. Sometimes you can be a pastor. You can be a prophet. Sometimes the moment you start the ministry, COVID-19 happened. You have already lost the place. Sometimes you don't have money to pay rent. Sometimes you asking yourself a lot of questions to say, what am I going to do? My brothers and sisters, be said to us those questions, knee down and speak to God. Speak to God. Remember the Bible says, God said, I will make a way, the place there is no way. So the place there is no way, God will make a way. In this situation you are going through, just believe in Him. Just believe in the word of God and to say, God will make a way. No matter what, no matter the problem happen, no matter what, we don't have money, but God will make a way. God, He will change, will make the impossible to make it to be possible, because we believe in His words. You know, I'm always said, sometimes some people they can have faith. Say, me, I've got a faith because somebody promised me to have money, to give me some money. Some people they can have a faith. That is a faith for promising. They're promising you. There is another faith. They tell you to say, tomorrow, come for interview. It is a faith also. You have a faith already. You say, okay, tomorrow I'm going for interview. Sometimes I can go after a faith interview. I can start a job. It's also a faith. So there is the third one is a faith. No one promising you. No one call you for interview. No one is talking to you about the job, but you have a faith now. You say, I have a faith in God. God, he will do something. God, he will make a way, the place there is no way. Because the Bible says, the just shall believe by faith. The just shall believe by faith. So the moment you confess this word with your heart, with your spirit and your thought, you confess it in you, you will see the miracle to be happen. Brothers and sisters, as I finish, don't lose your conscience. Don't lose your conscience. It is very important. Don't lose your conscience. No matter what, there is a problem. No matter what, there is a problem, sickness, a trouble. Don't lose your conscience. Still confessing the word of God. To say, God is in me. God is with me. The hope of glory. God is with me. The hope of glory. The moment you wake up early in the morning, worship God. To say, God, you are with me. And I believe in your words. I believe in you. I believe, God, you will make a way. And I believe, God, you release the miracle upon my life. You will see the greatness of the Lord. It will be upon you. Just believe to the word of God. Just believe. Today, you are in this situation. Tomorrow, your life it will change. People that can insult you. People that can speak the bad word upon your life. People that can pull you down. But what is the word of God that said among your life? You say you'll be successful. You'll be greater men. You'll be powerful woman. You'll be a greater man of God. You'll be a powerful man of God. In Jesus' mighty name, don't lose your conscience. Stand up with the power of God already released upon your life. God bless you. Wherever you are, I bless your life. I bless your ministry. I bless your job. In Jesus' name, and we pray. Amen. Amen. God bless you, brothers and sisters. Oh, please subscribe to our channel. It is also a great time, and to say you participate of to this ministry, and you contribute something to this ministry. Just subscribe and like our message. And please to put some commenter. You commenter also. Any question, just put it underneath. I'll be able to answer to you. God bless you. I love you. Bye-bye. See you on Sunday. Don't miss the service. God bless you.